Welcome to Oracle Marketing Cloud Help Center videos. In this video, we will cover how to create a lead scoring model. A lead scoring model in Oracle Eloqua lets you automatically qualify leads based on the demographic and behavioral characteristics that matter to your business. There are two dimensions to a lead scoring model, a profile score and an engagement score. The profile score is determined by explicit data on an account or contact, such as job role, industry, and revenue range. It helps identify prospects that are a better fit than others. Based on their fit, prospects are then given a score of A, B, C, or D. The engagement score is made up of implicit data that helps determine the level of interest the prospect has. For example, recently opening an email or visiting your website. Prospects are then given a score of 1, 2, 3, or 4. Blending the two elements, you arrive at a lead score, for example, A1 or B3. Now, while you could just go into Eloqua and start setting up your lead scoring model, you should take some time to discuss what yours will look like internally first. Here are some examples we've mapped out of what to do with prospects based on their lead score as a starting point. Let's get started by creating a lead scoring model together. In the top navigation, select Audience and then Lead Scoring. From here, click Create a Model. The Lead Scoring interface features two tabs, Profile and Engagement, in line with what we talked about earlier, and a panel containing different types of criteria. First, name your lead scoring model based on your company's naming conventions. I'll be naming mine Example Lead Scoring Model. Let's begin by configuring the profile portion. You can toggle between contact and account information. Use the search bar to find specific criterion. You can then drag or double-click them onto the page. For this example, I will choose job role, industry, and annual revenue. We recommend selecting 3 to 5 criteria. Now it's time to weigh the criteria based on importance. The more important it is to your company, the higher the weighting should be. You can adjust the weighting by dragging the slider. The remaining percentage can be seen at the bottom. Next, we need to add values for each criterion. The closer the value is to the ideal lead, the more points that value should be assigned. Double-click the criterion, then click Add Role. For this example, if a contact's job role contains executive, they will receive 100% of the available score for job role. If the lead is a director, they will receive 50% of this score, and if they're a manager, they will receive 25%. Then, click Save. If a contact meets multiple roles, Eloqua will assign them the higher score. Configuring the engagement portion is very similar. Simply drag the criterion you want onto the page. You should consider both the recency and frequency of the activity. In my example, I'm looking for leads that have opened emails, submitted forms, and visited our websites. Like before, we will weigh them accordingly. Now I'm going to create rules that define how contacts can earn points for each criterion. To do this, double-click a criterion, then click Add Rule. For this example, contacts that have opened 3 emails in the last 2 weeks will score 100% of the available score for opened email, and 75% for 1 email in the last 2 weeks. You'll want to set up rules for all the criteria in the model. Lastly, set the thresholds for the model. Thresholds determine the amount of points a contact needs for each profile and engagement score. Click Actions, then click Settings. Drag the slider above the bar to change the thresholds of each score. For example, a contact with a profile score of 70% and an engagement score of 35% will have a lead score of A4. Now you're ready to activate your lead scoring model. Click Actions, then click Activate. A confirmation dialog box will appear. Select one of the two options, then click Activate. The status button will then change from draft to active. Eloqua will then score all of your contacts and will continue to rescore them every 24 hours. This will help track your prospects and determine when a lead is hot enough to be passed over to sales. This concludes this tutorial on how to create a lead scoring model. Thank you for watching. For more information, go to topliners.com and click Know It.